Let's have some presenters. Really? It's okay? All right, go on up. Go on up. All right. All right, so using our purple prompts, would you like to make a comment, ask a question? Ellie will take those comments when she's ready.
Why don't you combine the 6x squared with the 17x?
Because you can't do like these two. Like, you know how it's combined like terms? These aren't like terms.
Because it's squared?
Yeah. Because like one is squared and one is just regular.
Miss, she obviously can't see. Would you please explain why you got 6x squared?
Because it's 2x plus 6x, so x times x is x squared.
Oh. Ellie, I noticed, or I wondered, did you say 2x times 6x? Times 3x? Okay. Okay, okay, okay. Just so everybody's clear. Right. Right, right.
What?
2x times 3x. Positive 2x times positive 3x. Vinny, what is that?
What? Are you asking me?
Positive 2x times positive 3x.
6x squared.
Perfect. What other questions do you have for Ellie? Are we ready? Okay, okay. Thanks, Ellie. All right. Adam has so graciously volunteered to present number two. Sure felt like you volunteered. Adam, may we stop you for a moment and have you tell us what you did and why you did it?
I divided 2 by 24 and 70, mm-hmm. 2. Mm-hmm. And it gave me half of, well, both of 70 and 24. Mm-hmm. And then I put it back into the equation.
Yeah. Is there anything you noticed that we need up there?
What?
We're missing something.
12 and.
Got it. Okay. Okay. All right. We're ready.
Well, this is as far as I got.
Okay.
And I found the two numbers that, when added, make 12 and multiplied make 35. Mm-hmm. And those 5 and 7.
Okay.
And that's how far I got.
Well, gee, that's quite a ways. So we can factor this trinomial into a product meaning multiply, of two binomials. Binomial meaning two terms. So how should we start? Give Adam some advice. How should we start?
It's kind of hard.
We can do hard stuff. We can do it. So ultimately, what form do we want?
Binomials.
Two binomials. So why don't we start just by creating the space for the two binomials? Why don't we start with the parentheses, two sets of parentheses? Okay. Adam, are you able to take it from here?
I watch. No, not really.
All right. So let's ask someone else. Where do we go from? Yeah, Melanie, please.
The 5 and 7 form.
Okay. Adam, what's the 5 and 7 they want to know?
When they're both added, they equal 12. When they're both multiplied, they equal 35. That's right. We got the numbers. When 5 and 7 are added, they equal 12. And when they're multiplied, they equal 35.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Does that help?
Yeah.
So let's fill in the two sets of parentheses. Where should we start? Yes. Yeah, don't be shy. You folks know this. We've done this before. What do you say, Jose?
I'm guessing the 5 and the 7, put them inside the parentheses.
Fine.
5 and
the
7.
5
and
the
7.
Is that what you were thinking?
I don't know how to explain it, but...
You want to go up and help?
The 7 was supposed to go on me.
Go help. Go help. You can do it. Oh, come on. It's okay. We can do it. I'll take your seat while you're gone.
What I was saying is that... Because the 5 and the 7 were right here, so what I was saying is just put the 5 inside of here, and like he did, just put the 7 inside of there.
So will you write it how you thought, please?
No, that's what I was basically...
Oh, is that what you were saying? Does everybody agree? Yes?
Yeah.
Absolutely, everybody? Where's the M? Where does the M go?
In the middle.
Well, okay, go show. Where in the parentheses? We got to get some M's in there.
Right here? Where at?
Yes? Anybody else? Is it time for me to step in and...
Yes.
I got everything twisted.
You're all just twisted up. Okay. All right. Anybody else? All right, I'm only going to provide a small bit of help. Don't leave, please. Oh, we're going red this time.
Can Jose sit down?
No. No, we're a team up here. We're not going anywhere. You say 5 and 7?
Yeah.
Yes.
Because they both have to be negatives.
Why?
Because
12 is negative.
Okay, so where do you want the gentleman to put those terms?
Why did you write the numbers like that inside the parentheses? Why did you write one at that end and the other one at that end?
We want a product of two binomials. So binomial meaning there are two terms inside. Some term plus or minus some other term times another binomial. Ellie's got her hand up.
So would one of them have to be positive and one of them have to be negative? Because if you do two negatives, it'll be a positive when you multiply them.
So you want two positives or two negatives or one of each? Okay, Alex?
Two negative, because a positive times a negative is a negative.
Exactly. Yeah, it has to be a negative for it to be
no,
negative.
Because he has 35. Or the last part is a positive 70.
You were talking about negative 12 earlier.
Well, like, I don't know. They both have to be negative, I think.
All right, we got a hand raised. Go ahead, my friend.
I agree with Alex that they both have to be negative because you said that when they add together, they have to equal negative 12, and when you multiply them, it has to equal positive 35. And if they're both negative, then negative 5 plus negative 7 is negative 12, and then negative 5 times negative 7 is positive 35.
Well, I'm not certain, but I think you need to get up here. I'm thinking we need you. Come on up. Come on. All right. Let's see what you think.
That makes sense.
Yeah, because
if you just five, negative five plus seven, I still put negative.
And then two negatives equal positive.
Oh, yeah.
All right. the team of three. Let's finish this up. What do we have? I heard we're supposed to have some M's.
Yes.
Okay, where do you want to put those, Adam?
In the parentheses.
Fantastic. Let's do that. So, are we okay?
Yes.
Something's missing. We're missing something. What are we missing?
I don't see negative 12 M in there. Or
is this from those?
2 M times 1 M equals 2.
So you, yeah, go ahead, Adam. What's missing? Okay, so let's put the 2 in, and it was on the outside of the trinomial. Let's keep it on the outside of the two binomials. All right, and then Amy has a question for you, Adam. Here she.
So when you go from, like, if you're going, because you have to multiply negative 5 times negative 7, how are you going to get 12?
Well, let's check and see if we're right. Let's do the opposite of factoring, which is expanding. So, all right, who's multiplying? Draw on the arrows. Go ahead. Go ahead, Adam. Draw your arrows, and let's work through this kind of quickly.